dear children, welcome back. Hope you all are enjoying your good health and doing well. So children, let us continue the remaining topics of the chapter 8, that is confrontation of the cultures. In this chapter, children, we saw how expedition done by Christopher Columbus encouraged other part of the country to do the tradings with the Central America and South America. With this, people started excavating different culture, for example, Aztec, Maya and Inca. Now, how this Aztec, Maya and Inca civilization was discovered and who became very powerful and how does they expand this empire? This is the story which we are going to discuss in this video. The very popular one who win the Aztec Empire was the Hernán Cortés. So the story of Hernán Cortés we will see with the help of video. And second, we will see the role of Pizarro, the Francisco Pizarro, who discovered the area of Maya. So children, let us discuss about three popular sailors or the travelers who arrived in the central and south portion of the America and invaded their territories. So let us see who were these, and they arrived from different part of the European country. Very popular was Hernán Cortés, which was from Spain, and he was a very popular sailor, and he heard about the Aztec that this place is very much enriched with the gold and silver. So with the greed to achieve gold and silver, he arrived in that place. Before that, he arrived to the Cuba. And from Cuba, he collected the number of soldiers and then put an attack towards the Aztec Empire. Now, after that, we will see the Francisco Pizarro, very interesting personality, who was also a Spanish. And he also, with the greed of gold and silver, invaded Inca Empire. And his desire was quite similar to the Cortés desire, and he followed how to achieve all these things with the help of his history. Now at last we will see about the Cabral, who invaded Brazil and established his empire. So this video is all about the conquest and the conquistors. So conquistors are those people who used to conquer the different part of the territory and became famous. So let us see with the help of video.
Hernán Cortés conquered one of the most powerful empire in the New World, claiming vast territory from the Mexico for the Spain. Growing up in Spain early 1500s, Hernán Cortés watched arriving ships regularly, laden with colorful textiles, spices, gold, from the Indies land of the so-called New World. In 1504, dreaming of gold for himself, Cortés boarded a ship for bound off Spanula, Spain's first prominent settlement in the Indies. He was 19 at that time, where Cortes saw Spain's influence in Spain. In Spain, encomienda system, all newly discovered lands were the property of crown and native people. Dino forced into the labor, creating wealth for Spain. Cortes lived in this land for 6 years. As contact between New World and the Europe, exploration and military expansion were on hand in hand. Soon Cortes joined an expedition that conquered Cuba and bought him prestige in both New World and Europe. Yet Cortes was ambitious and dreamed of more. The mainland of Mexico barely being explored by European, and there was a rumor of gold that Cortes couldn't ignore. In the direct order from the Cuba governor, Hernán Cortés led an expedition to the mainland of Mexico in 1519. He arrived in the Yucatán Peninsula with 11 ships and 600 men with 16 horses. Cortés quickly gathered information and cooperation from the local Indians, the Mayas. Well, their leader gave him 20 slaves. Among these was a lady who can speak the language of Maya as well as Aztec language called Navhut. She was an instrumental as a translator and as a navigator for them. Her name was Dania Marina in Dania Marina Spanish. Dania Marina told the great stories of the city Tenochtitlan, and Tenochtitlan was the capital city of the vast Aztec Empire, where priests and nobles remain engaged in the lavish ceremony in devotion of many Aztec gods. Aztec power reached from Pacific Ocean to the Gulf of Mexico, and anyone living in the territory was forced to pay tribute to the Aztec ruler Moctezuma. To conquer Mexico, Cortes have to defeat the Aztecs, known for the sacrifices of their enemies. Cortes and his soldiers marched and made a risky decision. He sinked his wounded ships. There would be no turning back. He would conquer the Aztec without any war. Thousands of Indians joined from Cortes' army to help him. Aware of his movement, Moctezuma sent gift for Cortes and his men for the strategy to avoid wars to gather the information. The Aztec had never seen the horses before. After hearing all Cortes' desire, Cuba governor decided to arrest Cortes. Finally, he saved the city Tenochtitlan. In August 13, 1521, Moctezuma died during the struggle and Cortes claimed the whole territory of Aztec. The story of Cortes conqueror was very popular in the history of Mexico. Francisco Pizarro was a Spanish conquistor who explored the Pacific coast of America and conquered the Inca Empire. He was born in Trizolo, Spain. He was illiterate. But was owned by the stories of exploiters of Pizarro's father and his countrymen in the Napoleonic War. He sailed from a fleet of 50 ships and carrying over 20,000 colonists. Pizarro accompanied the first voyage across the short space of land in Panama that linked the Caribbean and the Pacific Ocean of Isthmus Panama. Europeans to view the Pacific Ocean from the Central America. Pizarro befriended the governor of region and was eventually made magistrate and mayor of the Panama City. During this time, Pizarro heard the tale of legendary Inca city of Peru, set out to find the Inca Empire famed for its golden riches. After two failed expeditions, Pizarro and his friend finally landed in Peru and quickly established themselves with the native population and noted the great wealth of the people. Pizarro returned to Spain and prepared for his final expedition. by obtaining the support of king and made the governor of Peru, he landed the Ecuador in 1532. After several battles, he established a settlement in Peru and met with the Inca himself. Atahualpa refused to control by the Pizarro and resulting the Battle of Spain with the victory, and Atahualpa was executed by Gorti to the disagreement of his senior men. Pizarro went on the invade Cusco and conquer Peru. Pizarro founded the capital city of Peru, Lima, in 1535, but was killed in 1541 by the forces loyal to one of the Pizarro's rival, Diego de Almagro II. In April 1500, Portuguese sailor and explorer Pedro Cabral was on a mission heading to India. But his fleet went far west in the Atlantic Ocean and reached in a state of South America coast, where is Brazil now. The native of the land were instantly named Indians, as the Portuguese believed at first that they had reached India. After spending few days in Brazilian coast, Cabral and his men left for Calicut, where they would have arrived a few months later. Apparently, Cabral led the first known expedition to have touched four continents: Europe, Africa, the America, and the Asia. It's commonly accepted that the Portuguese reached Brazil by accident while distancing from the sea route to India. In fact, explorer might have been pushed by the exciting news about the tropical land found further west a few years before. For more than three centuries since Caribbean expedition, Brazil would be the part of the Portuguese Empire. Children, let's do some questionnaire. The main center of Inca civilization was Brazil, Peru and Florence, or Ecuador, Peru and Bolivia, America, Brazil and Peru, or none of these. Next question is, who was Pizarro? A traveler, an animist, a conquistor and a cosmographer. Answer all these questions in comment. Thank you for watching.